conveyance system. And how a open loop system works, as we have seen the stepper motor and gear reduction, then lead screw, and we have solved some numerical on that. So now we will go to the closed loop system. Not here. Open loop. Yes, closed loop system. As you can see, the components, there are extra components in the closed loop system. First one is comparator, then digital to analog converter. Then you see another here, instead of using servo motor, we are using stepper motor. Oh, sorry, instead of stepper motor, we are using servo motor. And then again, then here also the gear reduction is there, and then lead screw, and then this table. And one extra thing we have here at the end of the this shaft, lead screw shaft, we have optical encoder. It is not necessary that we have to attach it here. We can attach this end also, this end of this end. It will then it becomes the part of servo motor when we use optical encoder inside this optical encoder here, this component. If we include it in a motor, so that also becomes a part of servo motor. So as you can see, the normally used servo motor is DC AC and stepper motor, but when we use this one optical encoder or position control system, that becomes our servo motor. Servo motor is not another category of a motor. Just when we use with the feedback system, it become we call it in general term a servo motor when we use feedback system. So comparator compares here feedback system. Again, we have this comparator. This comparator compares with the input pulses and output pulses. It means we have to supply, suppose into open loop system, we have seen like 10,000 pulse was responsible, just for an example, 10,000 pulses were responsible to move the table, say 250 mm. Okay, so for example, 10,000 pulse has been supplied from the PLC, but due to the inertia, this lead screw or table may not move the exactly 250 mm. How much? 250 mm. So now the issue is how to identify lead screw has especially the table has moved 250 mm. That is the case. Okay, so what is the solution? Solution is, if somehow, listen carefully, if somehow, just like open loop system, as we have calculated 10,000 pulses were required, suppose to move the table 250 mm, but due to inertia, I am talking about open loop system this case first, and then I will connect it with the closed loop system. So in open loop system, but due to inertia, table may not move exactly 250 mm. It was required, it may move say 248 or in lower direction, or 200 say 53 in higher direction. So we are not exactly getting 250 mm. We needed this distance 250. So that is the error in our position system, and we need to control it. So how to control it? If somehow, as we know, the table movement is directly linked with the number of rotation and multiply with the pitch value, not the number of rotation. It is 1 turn of rotation, say, and it means 360 degree rotation and multiply with pitch value. So you will become 1 pitch value movement. So say if the angle of rotation is, say, total angle of rotation AS angle, and then it means we can identify how many number of turns this lead screw has rotated by dividing 360 degree. So total AS for lead screw and divide by 360 degree, it means we have identified number of rotation of this lead screw, and then we can multiply with the pitch value, so we can get the this axial distance x. So in that case, x is our 250. So what is required here? Pitch is constant. How to measure this AS angle? That is the case. So AS angle, to measure it, again we need number of pulses. So again we have number of steps here also, and step angle also, and then in one step it is moving alpha angle. So ns step it will move alpha into ns, that becomes 360 degree. So if you have supplied np pulses, say np pulses, see, one pulse alpha moment, one pulse alpha degree rotation of the lead screw. So np pulse, np into alpha, and that is our as value. This value np into alpha is our as value, correct? So if somehow, if we can measure the np value, that was, so if somehow if we are able to measure the np value, then this as into p, again as is equal to np number of pulses, and in one pulse alpha here alpha, so np into alpha, that is the rotation of total angular rotation of the lead screw. So our issue is only to count the number of pulses. So earlier cases, PLC was supplying input, this input value from the previous in stepper motor, but there was no provision to count the total number of pulses to move here, this direction, lead screw, because as I said, you need NP value. Say here N1 value. Can you consider the N1 and N2, this NP? Is there any difference? N1 and NP. N1 is we supplied from input, but NP is we are getting on the basis of axial displacement. On the basis of axial displacement, and that we have calculated based on this one, pitch multiply with number of rotation with pitch value, and AS from here NP into alpha, NP into alpha, and alpha is fixed, so only NP is left to find out, so that we can easily identify that for a particular distance, for a particular distance, in how many number of pulses required to move table. Okay, so only from the formula, this formula, AS by 360 into P is equal to doing X. Here X, put the value of X is equal to 250 degree, and AS is equal to NP into alpha. Alpha you can put, it is given step angle, So only NP value, pitch value is also given. So pitch value of the lead screw also given. So only NP value, you can calculate the NP value. As you can see, this N1 value does not depend on linear displacement of the table. So we need to identify what is the exact NP value that is responsible for the motor to move 250 mm. Okay, so suppose like I was talking about in open loop system. So PLC was responsible to generate the pulses. So first case 10,000 and 10,000 in open loop. But as we have calculated from NP value from this side, that it requires, say, for example, 10,200. That we need 10,200 pulses to move the table. And now you can see why we are getting this much difference. Because, as I said, due to the inertia, table may move lower or down, higher. If it is moving higher, that means we need to reduce the number of pulses. So it may be 9,060 like this. If some distance it is going beyond, if table is going beyond, then we need less pulse, 9,960. Okay, so a small number of pulse we need if the table is moving beyond. So it is happening due to the inertia, acceleration. And that's we this value we measure it with the help of optical encoder, and we try to control the movement of the table with the help of the comparator. So the input continuously compared with the output of the shaft, here lead screw. So if one pulse supplied and same time this optical encoder control measure the rotation, one pulse, one step angle, but here this optical encoder will measure that whether the lead screw has moved one step angle or not. Suppose for one step angle, here one pulse is responsible for only half step angle movement for the lead screw. So for to get the one step angle moment of lead screw, again we need another pulse. So two pulse will be responsible for one moment of one step angle. Now you know why it is happening due to the inertia, because due to inertia, table may move faster or slower. And that's why we need to control the moment of the table and inertia of the table, acceleration of the table, deceleration of the table, and it is done simultaneously with the help of feedback system that we have employed, and in optical encoder is used to measure the number of rotation here of the this lead screw. Okay, so it measures the number of rotation in the form of again generating a pulse. So for one pulse and one it will generate one pulse, and for two pulse if it is generating two pulse, so it is the system is working fine. But for one pulse, say three pulse, here we have supplied three pulse and here we are getting two pulse, it means there is a lag in one pulse. So again, optical with the feedback system, this comparator will generate more pulse to that is required to move the table exact position. So pulses are generated continuously from the PLC, but the exact number of pulses are given from the optical encoder. What I said, the exact number of pulses that is required, that is counted from the optical encoder. Is that okay? Earlier in open loop, we were using only the input pulses that we supply with the PLC. But here we count number of pulses from the optical encoder, and that we supply here. So comparator compares the
input pulse and our output here, output of the encoder pulses, and then with the help of digital analog converter, again signal is generated. This generate signal, and that signal converted into digital to analog, and then analog signal like voltage drive the servo motor. Tell me, do you have any doubt in this working principle? How does it work? If I am cleared this topic, then I will move ahead. I need your response. If anyone having any kind of doubt, because once you have got the understanding how does it work, then we can move. Okay, let me explain one more time. See, suppose there is no feedback system, what will happen? We supply N1 pulse from input, and directly through the PLC, it is PLC, and then controller, and then controller to signal pulse directly to the motor in the form of signal. So we have through the PLC controller, and the it goes to servo motor. Again, this I am talking about first case open loop, then I will connect again with the closed loop. So again, here stepper motor, it as number of pulses divided by multiply with angle alpha, so that turns it rotates motor AM angle. What is the AM value? One pulse responsible for alpha rotation, NP pulse, N1 pulse responsible for again this much angle for motor shaft. But due to gear reduction, RG value, sometimes we will have lesser angular rotation of the lead screw. So it we will divide that value N1 alpha by RG. That is for open loop system AS. It is AS. But as you know, due to inertia based on AS, so that is the total angle. If we divide by 360 degree, we can count the number of turns. So AS by 360 degree, that is number of turns. And in one turns, table moves P value, that is pitch value. So this number of turns, table will move this much value, that is your X, positional value of X. It means the distance required to move the table from one position to another position, you say it as a X. Okay, but what is the drawback here? As we have used N1 AS includes N1 into alpha. Alpha is fixed, RG fixed, P fixed. We need X, so it is also fixed. Only difference is N1 value. But due to inertia, although we are supplying, but table will not move exactly the same distance X. So instead of counting the number of pulses from this direction, we count the number of pulses from optical encoder. So if optical encoder counts, say NP pulse, and in one pulse step lead screw moves alpha angle, so that becomes our AS angle, total angular rotation of the lead screw, NP into alpha. Now you see NP here, AS becomes our NP. I am talking about closed loop system, NP into alpha. Now you see there is a difference between this value and this value. So we are not counting in closed loop system, we are counting this one. And based on this, if we multiply with the pitch value, we will get divide by 360 degree, and then multiply pitch value, we will get the axial position. Okay, so our main focus is to count number of pulses from this side, optical encoder side. Okay, we don't count, and based on that N1 and NS value, the comparator provides the generates the signal. If it is less, it generates more. Suppose you need exactly NP value. So in case N1 and NP, N1 is exactly, if N1 is greater than NP, then in that case only NP signal will be generated. N1 is equal to NP, no problem. NP signal generated through the comparator and it will go and table will move exactly same position. In case N1 less than NP, it means number of pulse from input is less than NP. So in that case, more NP generated, more pulse required, and comparator will generate more pulses, and then it will go through the servo motor and then table will move exactly the same position. Now you tell me, I have cleared this concept or not? Will you tell me or not?
Yes, sir.
Roni. Bhargav.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, thank you for your response. Now we see optical encoder. What we have here in optical encoder, we will attach it with the, as I you have seen, we attach it generally at the end of the lead screw or at the start of the lead screw. We can also attach in some way. So it becomes a part of motor, and that's why we call it a servo motor when we attach it this kind of system, optical encoder. Okay, so we generally in common term we call it as a servo motor. Okay, so first thing, it is attached to the lead screw shaft. Okay, then optical encoder has this disc, and on that disc slots are there, these slots. So we call it an encoder disc. Then we have the light source. Okay. And with light source, we have photodetector cell. So whenever a slot comes directly in front of light source passes and light falls on optical encoder photo cells here. So once light falls on this, a signal is generated. So we get intermittent signal like this one here, signal at present, and then in this gap when there is no slot, no absent of signal, and then next slot will be responsible for generating another signal, and then next this part, solid part, will not allow light source to pass, so no signal, and then next slot will come in front of this, so another signal will be generated. So as you can see, the first signal, second signal, third signal, and fourth signal. So based on this, number of signal will come being generated. Okay, so that is the pulse 1, 2, 3, 4 pulse we are generating here, and that NP into alpha, if we multiply one pulse responsible for one angle alpha, so we will get NP into alpha, that is responsible for AS angle, step number of rotation of lead screw shaft, NP into alpha. So what we have here, It is a device for measuring rotational speed, position and speed, and then common feedback sensor for closed loop system, that is very common, that is used for the closed loop system. So I hope what we need to understand. We need to understand that there is an optical encoder, there is a light source and encoder disk, and then these are the slots and this photo cell. So light source passes whenever, as this one is mounted on a lead screw. So if the motors are rotated through gear reduction, lead screw will rotate, and then whenever the slot comes, a light will falls on the photo cell, a signal will be generated. That is the concept. So here we count the number of pulses, 1, 2, 3, 4. In this way we count the number of pulses. We don't count it, generally is a part of circuit dead count. So here we have, as you can see, this can be mounted on a lead screw, then, and here the whole system is an optical encoder in that inbuilt LED light, and then photo sensor or photo cell, and here again squaring circuit mechanism. So signal is like this form. So this type of signal will be generated. Okay, so some part of signal will be chopped off and some part of the signal will be generated. So in the form of square, and this one optical encoder disk you see here. Again, you can learn more about optical encoder on this link in detail. Okay, so I hope it is clear. So again, now I need to tell one more thing here. Step angle, how to identify step angle. Again, you see number of slots in the optical encoder. So this one and this one, so it becomes our one step angle. Either you consider it this much or between two slot, you can not taking two slot only in this way, or draw, or between this one to this one. It is the same like pitch, like in screw thread we have this one. So either you can measure the pitch from root to root or crest to crest, the both are same. The same way here, this is one step angle. In one step, one slot, another step, one slot. So in this way, slot angle. So if suppose there are 36 slot, so step angle would be 360 degree divided by 36, 10 degree, that is one step. So it means the one step it will move 10 degree. Okay, so this one is step angle, and one step it moves, it generates one pulse. So one step is responsible for generating one signal. So another slot will come and it will generate another signal. Signal means another pulse. So in this way we count the number of pulses from the encoder. So what we have in the closed loop position system, as you know, like step angle. I told you that if there are 36 last, so we calculated the step angle 10 degree. So if there are ns for slot, so ns slot, so we will have the step angle this way. So angle between slots in the disk must satisfy the following relation: alpha is equal to 360 by ns, where alpha is the angle between slot, that is degree per slot, and ns is the number of slots in the disk that I calculated based on taking the 36 slot, alpha 10 degree per slot. Okay. Again, for a certain angular rotation of the encoder shaft, the number of pulses sensed by the encoder. So, suppose now as we have got this one, if suppose as we have seen, for x distance was mainly responsible for rotation of AS angle. AS. So if we can find AS value, we can find the x value. So to find the AS value, we need how much pulse we need to generate, how much pulse we need to generate from the optical encoder. So how we will get, as we know, in one rotation, that means one rotation 360 degree, that is we are getting number of ns step as step angle alpha is given. So if total number of AS angle we have to rotate, so AS angle, and in one angle or one step or one pulse alpha angle, and total angle is AS. Listen again. One pulse responsible for rotation of alpha angle, and if our total angle is AS, total angle I am talking about, not considering how many number of turns, it means it may turn 2, 3, 5,000, 10,000, and that we already counted in the AS total angle. Okay, so for example, only one rotation 360 degree, two rotation 720 degree, and likewise. So one pulse is responsible for alpha angle rotation. So if total angle of angular rotation of rediscrete shaft is AS, then how many number of pulses we need? We simply divide by alpha, and that becomes our number of pulses. This value. Again, as we know, alpha is step angle. So again, we can divide our yes, alpha is equal to h. We can use this one. So alpha 360 by ns, ns will come into the numerator. Yes, ns by 360. Remember these two formula, where np pulse count emitted by the counter, and as angle, angle of the rotation of the encoder shaft. So these are emitted on optical encoder. Np pulse. Then next, what we have? The pulse count can be used to determine the distance moved by the work table along the x-axis. As you can see, x distance, if we have this pulse count, so how much distance it is moving based on this np. P is the pitch value, number of pulses, and ns number of step angle, and p, what does it mean? It means we are generally counting the total number of rotation, angular rotation, number of rotation, and then we are multiplying. See, if this one is a lead screw, so in one rotation it will move in one pitch value. So if one rotation and
number of steps angles are there. So one rotation I'm talking about. So ns steps are there, and if somehow as ns steps required and ns pulse, if ns say for example say 36, so exactly to move 36 step we need number of pulses, that is 36 np. So if we, and suppose, and if we are supplying 72 pulse, so can we identify how many turns it has rotated? Obviously by dividing ns value is 36, so two rotation, so in two rotation it will, lead screw will move to pitch value. So that's why we are using np by ns and p. Okay, so again np value we have calculated as by np value alpha. So we will replace only np value here and we will get this value also. Again we can replace the ns into alpha, as we know ns into alpha number of step and one step angle, that becomes 360 degree. So we have this value also. Again the velocity of the work table, also the feed rate in the machining operation, that is velocity of the table, or that is also the feed rate, is given by rotation per minute multiply with the pitch value. So it, our linear velocity. Again ns is the, as we can see, the number of rotation we supply it from the motor. So when we are using gear ratio, so we can use nm by rg into p. Okay, then again we have reach. Pulse frequency, see this. One pulse is responsible. See, one pulse is responsible for moment of one alpha degree or one slot angle. So FP pulse, that is, I am talking about FP pulse. FP pulse will be responsible for FP into alpha degree. Okay, so if somehow okay, correct, FP into alpha, that is the total number of our FP pulse, this is total angle, this one FP into alpha is total angle. So if we multiply, and we need to know this one total angle in 1 second as we concept of frequency. So this one is the FP into alpha, that is moment in 1 second. So again we have this value in 60 second. Can we identify? Just multiply with the FPL into alpha into alpha into 60 FP, that is the number of what? In 60 second angle rotation. Okay, so if we divide by ns,
had FP into alpha, that is total angle in 1 second rotation. So 60 second, it is this one. And then if in one rotation, number of steps angle are given. So in this total angular rotation, what we have divided by NS step angle. Okay. And that is our number of angular rotation, and we multiply with the pitch value. That means that becomes our VT value. VT is equal to and multiply with the pitch value. So we get this formula. FP 60 P and VT, as we had, VT is equal to pulse frequency, total number of pulses. Okay, wait a minute. Wait a minute. See, FP pulse, one pulse responsible for alpha degree moment, one pulse. FP pulse is given, but we need to identify number of angular rotation, number of. So FP pulse is given. So if we divide NS value, number of steps, so we can get the total angular number of angular rotation. Okay, and then we will multiply with the pitch value, we will get the axial distance. Okay, so based on that, again for 1 second, for 60 second, this one is for 1 second axial displacement, and we multiply, take it for 60 second, so that is our velocity, that becomes our velocity. So from that we have calculated, find out the FP is equal to VT into NS, VT into velocity table of velocity of the table, VT into NS divided by 60P, and same, replace the VT from FR feed rate and VT, both are same, as you can see here. So here we completed. Again, I am repeating this one. See, FP, what is FP? FP is the number of pulses in 1 second. Pulse frequency, that we call it. So, if FP is given, so can we identify how much angle it is rotating, or how many angular rotation? So simply divide by NS value, we can get the total number of angular rotation. It means it is turning 1 or 2, 3, 4 like this, based on this formula. And then in one, it is per second. So in one turn, as one complete turn, pitch value moves. Okay, so this much turn we will multiply with the P, and it is per second. So for making it per minute, we have this one, and then it is our velocity of the table or feed rate of the tool. So FP by NS is equal to P into that we have written here. So here, and numerical we will complete in next class. Okay.